Hi, my name is Isha, and you're watching Garneau News.
On the agenda, movie Valentine's Day.
Let's check it out.
I just wanna take you anywhere that you like. We could go out any day, any night. Baby, I'll take you there, baby, I'll take you there, yeah. Oh, tell me how to turn your love on. You can get anything that you want. Baby, just shout it out, baby, just shout it out, yeah. And if you want me to, let's make a oh, baby, don't you know you got what I need? Looking so good from your head to your feet. Come over here, yeah. Oh, I just wanna show you off to all of my friends. Making them drool out of chinny chin chins. Baby, be mine tonight, baby, be mine tonight.
So are you guys excited for Valentine's Day?
Yep.
Yes.
Who came up with the idea for doing this?
We did as an entire club of Habitat for Humanity.
Why are you giving this back to us?
Oh, that's cool. Do you guys want to talk about your club more? Like,
well, all we do is fundraise and...
Yeah, we fundraise and we raise awareness because since this is the first frontline Habitat for Humanity club in Ontario, we obviously have to come up with our own roadmap. So a roadmap as in we have to come up with our own fundraisers, ways to raise awareness.
Yeah,
and basically find a hardworking executive team, and that's what we've been doing. So for this specific idea, we asked our club members, you know, like, what do you guys want to do for Valentine's Day? Because we realized that there wasn't going to be a bake sale. So to get like money involved in our process of fundraising.
Yeah, we just had a photo booth and
oh my god,
just to raise money. And, like, we took pictures and then we're decorating it and delivering it to people.
Yeah, but we definitely won't take the credit of who came up with the idea because it was honestly a consensus of our entire club.
Yeah.
Thank you.
just want to take you anywhere that you like. We could go out any day, any night.
So the next thing we're going to be presenting to you are responses from Winterfest.
I know my rent was going to be late about a week ago. I worked my, but I still can't pay it though. But I got just enough to get off in this club.
Hi, my name is Jimmy. I went to Sky Zone for my Winterfest trip. And basically, what we did, we were jumping around on trampolines, and I was dunking.
Skating for Winterfest, and it was a lot of fun. We skated for like a few hours, and then we got hungry, so we went Jackass with friends.
I went to Sky Zone, and it was fun.
We went to rinks and it was well organized. We got to go rollerblading and we went bowling as well. There was bumper cars there and we played glow-in-the-dark mini golf. We didn't get to play laser tag because it was already full, but other than that, it was really well organized. The teachers there were nice and the people there were nice with, to us, so I enjoyed myself a lot.
So we're back with and we're gonna ask some more questions about Winterfest. So where did you go for Winterfest?
I went shopping.
Where did you go?
Was it fun?
Yeah.
What did you guys do?
Okay, so this is your first year in Garneau, right? So what do you guys think about Winterfest and like the activity and stuff like that?
It's pretty fun.
Fun? Are you guys
going to
next year?
Don't you have to?
Yeah, you kind of have to.
Hey, Garneau News. So I'm here with Live Up in grade 9, and we're going to ask her about Winterfest.
Okay, so did you go to Winterfest this year?
Yeah, I did.
Where'd you go? Did you go with like your friends? Was it fun?
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
What did you guys do at Rinks?
So there was bowling, there was laser tag, there was bumper cars, roller skating, of course.
Sounds like so much fun! Okay, do you guys like need anything?
Yeah, we have to like the cookies and drinks.
Are you gonna go next year?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, so we're here with, what's your name?
Fahad.
Where did you go to for Winterfest?
I went to Bali.
You went, the Bali one in Rama.
Yep.
Oh, was it fun?
Yes.
Did you go with like your friends and stuff like that?
Actually, yes.
Did you guys like eat or anything?
I went first.
Yeah.
To Bolrama with Miss Ryan.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. And I had at Target.
Oh, you went to Target? Yeah, it's closing down, right?
I know.
Yeah.
I had a passenger there, right? And then I went to the cafeteria.
Yeah.
And sat down.
Yeah.
And I bought a water bottle. From Muntsir goodies.
Oh wow! Yeah. Where do you think you're gonna go to Winterfest next year?
Well, next year, I'm thinking of going to downtown.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, it'll be fun, right?
Yeah,
okay, thank you. Okay, so we're here with our favorite vice principal, Mr. Sharp, of course, and we're gonna ask him about Winterfest. Okay, so where'd you go for Winterfest?
I was at Harborfront.
Was it really cold?
It was very cold. Right? It was one of our coldest years for Winterfest, no question.
Do you actually put on some skates and skate yourself?
No, I don't skate myself. I used to skate many years ago, but I don't skate anymore. What I did was deal with making sure everybody got skates and helmets and had their helmets on and all the compliance things that a vice principal has to do.
Of course, safety first, mm-hmm. Right?
Board policy.
So do you get pretty busy with all the forms and everything coming in last minute and stuff?
I get busy with the forms last minute. There are a lot of changes at last minute as people finally realize that it's coming and they want to be with their friends and they haven't really planned their lives well.
Yeah.
And a lot of people who don't make up their minds till the last minute. But a large amount of it is done in advance thanks to Mrs. Woods, who prepares all the forms in June and gives them to me, and then I post them on the school website, and we get a large number of students who register as we hope them to in the August registration. I would say I've probably had over 600 to 700 students register as part of registration, which is what we want.
being prepared?
Well, it's you get a better selection. If you wanted to go to Mini Indy, it was sold out by the third day of
Mini
registration,
Indy's
right?
Sold out,
exactly.
Right?
So if you don't come prepared, you aren't going.
Oh, okay. So do you have any new activities or anything coming for Winterfest next year, or is it?
We keep checking. Okay, so this year we added a food tour, which is a new activity. I tried to add a salsa dancing workshop, where I thought it was great. You get 30 people, you learn to salsa dance, they prepare you a Mexican lunch, and then you learn to, I think it was rumba in the afternoon. It was this full day of dance, and not one person wanted to take it. I didn't get one taker. So we keep trying things. I'm going to talk to famous people players and see if they have a show going that day that maybe we could take some people to. I've got actually got a list on my desk of things. That there's a sweets tour I think I'm going to investigate. And see if maybe the ACC or Skydome have tours that would coincide with this. We're looking for anything we can to give people a variety of choices. What was really successful this year is we switched our snow tubing location to the Rock, and everybody who went snow tubing had a blast. Their only complaint was it didn't last long enough.
Yeah.
So we're going to try to figure out a way. The reason some of the trips are as long as they are is because the school buses that take us places have to be back in time to do their regular school bus route, and they can't leave until they've done their regular school bus route. So it's a lot. It's a big juggling act. It's like putting together a big jigsaw puzzle to make sure everything works.
So a lot of people were, of course, complaining about the cold weather.
Yes, it's
and
Canada.
They were
deal
asking
with it.
Why there isn't like a Winterfest, but for like the summer. Why is it specifically in
it's
the winter?
It's called summer break. And they get 2 months to do Summerfest. Do enjoy it.
Okay.
When will we do a Summerfest? In June we can't do it because we have exams and summatives and we can't take a day and do it then.
Yeah. But is there a specific reason why it's in February? Like March or like April when it's a bit warmer.
Okay, well, warmer is the relative. Like if you want to go skiing in April, usually you can't. You can't go snow tubing. Skating is iffy. They usually close the rinks in the city of Toronto at the end of February. So this year was particularly cold in our terms. I have a friend who's in Toronto this week, and she's from Iqaluit.
Oh, so
it's been minus 50 to minus 60 every day all winter for her.
Yeah.
She came down to Toronto. She went for a walk because it was so nice. She didn't have to put her snow pants on. So it's all relative.
Yeah,
it was cold. But if you dress for it,
then
you can survive. The people who went skiing were cold but had a good time because they knew enough to dress well. The people who came skating without mitts might have been a little cold.
Yeah. Okay, so do you want to add anything?
No, that's fine. I don't think there's anything. Make sure you sign up early next year because you need to participate in Winterfest. Make Miss Goldenberg happy.
Okay.
I know my rent was gonna be late about a week ago. I worked my but I still can't pay it though. But I got just enough to get off in this club. Have me a good time before my time is up. Hey, let's get it now. Ooh.